or hopefully help can be sent to these patients as quickly as possible. Now let's move on. The government has boasted of its many achievements, although it is still crippled by the challenge of corruption. Now also the State Minister for Economic Monitoring, Peter Ogwang, has today released the program for the Independence Day celebrations on October 9th.
59 years back, Uganda achieved its Independence Day, and this year's celebrations will be held on Saturday. Since the country has registered some strides, making it better off than it was before achieving its independence. Peter Ogwang, the state minister in charge of economic planning, said Ugandans have a reason to celebrate, citing a number of achievements registered, ranging from the improved economy, improved education system, better health services, improved security, better roads, increased agriculture production, among others.
In the education sector, in these 59 years of independence, we have done a lot to build economic and administrative capacity to implement the development decisions we rightly make as a free nation and as free people. We have addressed all the needs and built the intellectual capacity of our people in terms of health and education delivery. We have invested a lot in educating our people using new and refocused circular. It is true we have problems in this area, but we also made impressive gains and we shall continue to do so. For example, we have increased the number of primary schools to cover the 10.78 million pupils. Agriculture remains the main thrust of Uganda's economic growth. It employs about 64% of Ugandans and about 72% of all young people, highlighting its importance to house and hold income growth. The value of agriculture export has increased over time to US dollars 1.5 billion, representing a growth of the last four financial years.
But of course, there's still a lot more to be done. The minister decried the high level of corruption, which is still crippling the economy.
Many achievements have been registered over the last 32 years, but we must increase our collective vigilance in the fight against those vices that derail our road to full modernization. Vices like corruption in public offices, poor service delivery, all forms of sectarianism and tribalism, for us to be able to promptly and efficiently achieve Vision 2040 as a transformed and a prosperous Uganda.
The Independence Day again comes at a time when the country is still grappling with COVID-19 pandemic. According to the program, the celebrations are to be held scientifically with only 600 people invited at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds. President Museveni is expected to be the chief guest. This year's celebrations will run under the theme Celebrating Our 59th Independence Day as We Secure Our Future Through National Mindset Change.
And all the other well-meaning patriots who fought for Uganda to be free from the colonial exploitation and attain her self-rule. It's a debt we can neither repay or ever forget. And so, few invited Ugandans will, on 9th October 2021, gather at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds to remember and celebrate this great day. Because of the COVID-19 pandemic still roaming large, this year's celebrations will be scientific. In other words, few invited people, that is to say we shall have 600 of them, will be in Kololo, while the rest of Ugandans will quietly celebrate from their homes.
This story was compiled by Jaliat Namoya for the news in Kampala.